Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky in the Lab-RAT-ory back with another short clinic. This continues the weathering process of our tires in the Death Stalker. So I'm going to show you what we've done here. And again, remember that we used MIG products in this order, these three colors. We used rubber and tires. This is ammo by Mig Jimenez, and rust tracks, and then finally dust. Now I'm going to show you also that if for whatever reasons you are concerned about getting paint inside your wheel wells, then you know, use putty. Silly putty is a great way of masking. It's not my technique. It's not my tip or, you know, or trick. It's been around for a long, long time. So we're just using what we've heard works and having fun doing so. So here are the finished weathered tires. Okay. Now, as you can see there, it's very subtle. You don't want to bombard your tires with all sorts of stuff. You want to keep it reasonable, okay? But you begin to see a little bit of that, you know, gray and rust color, and then the dust. A little goes a long ways, my friend and friends. And also you see the application of the wash. You could still see a lot of the chrome. You know, just basically a glint in there, just a little bit. It's very subtle, but these tires are dirty. Now, what's the story behind the kind of weathering that we're doing? Well, this is going to be an urban zombie hunter all-terrain vehicle. I mean, this thing will go over cracked cement, rubble, dusty shoulders on the side of the road, you name it. So we wanted to already start representing some of that. Now, is the weathering process on these tires done? No. Once they get back on the vehicle, you can continue the weathering process. And now, one of the things that we love to do here in the laboratory is, of course, you know, variety. So don't make all your tires look the same, all right? Change them up, right? And you see that they will look different. Now, I take my own medicine here. So we had painted three tires, and by the time we got to the fourth, we said, well, they're all going to look more or less the same. So look what we did. We took some blue paint, and once again, we lowered the PSI on the Neo, on our airbrush, and got it to spatter. And so we got, look at that. We got a little bit of that blue spattered on one of the tires. Again, visual interest. Random is good. Random will get people to notice your models. You know, it's a focal point of sorts. So we got a little bit of that blue paint spattered on there, and we love it. So, you know, we didn't feel like doing it in the back, but what's the story behind that? I don't know. It went over a can of a rattle can of paint. Somebody threw a paint Molotov cocktail on it. We don't know, but we really enjoy the process. And of course, as always, our handy dandy Iwata Neo, which we've been using pretty much exclusively now over the last few builds. You've seen this puppy do both shiny. This is what we used to paint the Super Bad Big Bird, which we're still working on. And now this one, as well as a few other projects. So, anyway, hope you're enjoying this series. There will be more, and we once again thank you for your ongoing support. Your support matters a lot to us. When you visit the Cranky store, it helps us create new content and continue on with the show. All right, my friends, more Cranky Show coming right up.